Hi y'all, it's Andrea over at Sewspire.com, and today I am here with the last video in our RRRR series, which was all about reducing, reusing, recycling, repurposing, refashioning, and so forth. This is gonna wrap it up. We are making a laptop sleeve that is zippered. It has a wraparound zipper. The exterior is wax canvas, and then the recycling portion or refashioning comes in because the interior is that beautiful cashmere sweater that I showed you all. I am so happy with the amount of padding and protection that I feel this sweater lends this design. So if you do happen to have a sweater, the cashmere is perfect for this because you can cut it and it will not fray, that you no longer care for, or perhaps it needs to be mended or something. You will just need two pieces that measure 11 by 14 inches for this project. If you wanted to use new material for the outside, that also measures 11 by 14. All of the measurements and such are in the notes, so please scroll down. But without further ado, shall we get started? Okay, for this project, you're gonna need a 22 inch long separating zipper. This happens to be a Coates and Clark Sport separating zipper, which works very well. You're going to need four pieces of material that measure 14 inches across by 11 inches high. I am repurposing a cashmere sweater for the lining, and this is like wool, very nice. It won't fray when you cut it. I did machine wash and dry this sweater before cutting it. And then I have, for the exterior, two pieces of slate gray waxed canvas. So I really like the idea of combining these two fabrics together. I think that by itself is going to make an awesome design. If you're not familiar, the wax canvas is water resistant, and when you crumple it up like that or through normal use, it will attain this kind of aged leather-like patina, which is a lot of fun, and I think is gonna add quite a bit of character to this piece when paired with the cashmere. I wanna begin with the exterior, and I'm just gonna work with one panel here, and I want to position the zipper with the right side facing down on the right side of the wax canvas, so that zipper pull is facing down. And I'm just gonna pin that in place so that it comes from this top left-hand corner and then around the right-hand corner. And once I have that pinned in place, then I'm gonna go ahead and unzip and separate that zipper so just the one piece of the zipper remains attached. And that is the benefit of using the separating zipper, because it makes it much easier to sew if you don't have all of that bulk. So for this corner, just kind of angle that zipper. I don't recommend clipping that. You just want a soft curve, and you can attain that no problem. And then I have that pinned on there, so I'm going to go ahead and remove that piece for the moment and then stitch that zipper in place. I have made it around, and you can see that zipper is attached. The blue and the slate gray look gorgeous together. Now I want to go ahead and reattach that zipper so that it functions properly. And I'm going to bring over my second wax canvas panel and just lay this portion with the zipper on top of that. You want to align the bottom edge because you can clearly can see that, and that will ensure everything's even. And then just pin the remaining side of the zipper tape to the second wax canvas panel. And then once you get that pinned in place, you will unzip that zipper again to attach the zipper tape to that second panel, just as we did for the first panel. Go ahead and stitch that second side of the zipper onto that second wax canvas panel. And I have that second zipper attached to the second panel. Now, working with either panel, you just want to make sure that zipper is lying flat, and then take your interior panel, which in my case is the sweater, and you're going to position that right sides facing with that zipper panel and just line everything up as best you can. You can pin it if you like. For me, this cashmere grips that wax canvas, so I think I'm going to be okay without pins, and I'm just going to stitch right along very close to that same stitch line that I used to attach the zipper to that wax canvas. And I want to attach this panel just in the same areas that the zipper is attached. Okay, so across the top and down that side. When you turn that right side out, you should begin to see those panels coming together and how that sweater is going to line the case, and then that wax canvas will become the exterior. So I'm going to repeat that process with the second panel, just pressing down that zipper so it lays flat, and then positioning the interior panel right sides facing and attaching that right along that same stitch line that we used to attach the zipper. So the top and the side. Now you want to turn both panels so that the right sides are facing out. So, and your zipper will function, and you're going to go ahead and attach that zipper. Like that. And then you want to turn the piece wrong side out, so the zipper is inside out, and you're just going to peel back that interior and only work with the exterior. So before you begin, you're going to have to open that zipper just a little bit, enough that you can reach your hand inside of there, so just 3 or 4 inches. And then peel back that interior on both sides, and you're going to align the exterior, which in my case is the wax canvas, and then stitch from this left-hand side to the corner, pivot, and go ahead and stitch all the way up to the zipper as close as you can get. Okay, and then go ahead and keep that zipper open. And now you want to peel up the interior layers and align those corners. And we're going to do the same thing and stitch from the left to the right, but we are going to have to leave an opening to turn this. So leave approximately 4 inches back stitch on either side towards the base of this so you can turn it, and then continue and go all the way up the side, aligning that side seam and getting as close as you can to the zipper. So right now we have something that kind of looks like a fortune cookie or a hot mess. But once you turn this right side out, it actually is going to be wonderful. So you're going to reach in through the hole that you left in the base of the interior, and then go ahead and open that zipper a little wider, and then turn everything right side out. And now that you have it turned around, you can go ahead and unzip that completely. And you should really see your case taking shape. It's okay if that zipper separates, because that's why we chose a separating zipper. Now you want to turn it inside out again, and then to separate that lining from the exterior, and fold that opening inward a bit there, and then stitch that closed. This sweater is super forgiving because it has lots of stretch, so it's a great material to work with. If you're working with a cotton or something that has a little more stability, I would go ahead and press that before you stitch it. And then another awesome benefit was that the stitches just sink right into that sweater and you can't even see them. Okay, so now all I have to do is turn this right side out and reconnect the zipper. And then I have a seriously stylish and super silky soft on the inside, yet very durable and water resistant exterior. And as you can see, this fits the MacBook Pro perfectly. So if you have a bigger unit, you're going to want to adjust those measurements. And for your planning purposes, my MacBook measures 12.5 inches across by 8.75 inches tall. And then on the diagonal there, we're at 14.75 inches. So I hope you all enjoyed this project. You could totally craft this from new materials or completely from found materials. I was just really inspired to combine that luxurious cashmere with this rugged masculine wax canvas. Super thrilled with the outcome. I did not use any batting or interfacing, and I feel like that sweater offers this computer a lot of protection and padding. All right, so it was an absolute pleasure to sew with you. This project is going to conclude our series. Reduce, reuse, recycle, repurpose, refashion. There were so many R's that came into play. It did not go as long as I'd hoped, but I believe this is the 4th or 5th video in the series, and spring has sprung. The sun is coming into the studio now, and I'm ready to move on to another project. Next week, we're going to start sewing a spring tunic. If you remember from the very first video in this series, that is something that I've wanted to do for a really long time. This next tunic, though, is going to be crafted completely from new fabric. I have picked out my fabric on Hawthorne Threads, and I am going to be ordering that this week. So as soon as that arrives, I'll start recording that video. Until then, as always, please know the creative genius in me will be celebrating the creative genius in you. Have a beautiful week, everyone.